join. Do join the Women's Forum tomorrow night, ladies. Third Thursday of the month, 7 p.m. at Bond in Los Angeles. Joel Friday TV coming up after Hake. Indeed. Coming up after Hake. What else is going to be happening? It's American Anchor Baby after Joel Friday TV. Can you hear me, guys? Yes. It is 9:01 a.m. U.S. Pacific Standard Time here in Los Angeles. Wednesday, the 14th of February. Happy Valentine's Day. Happy Valentine's Day. I remember as a little kid, I would distribute the Valentines. We would get the names of every classmate and distribute the Valentines to every single classmate. Can you believe it? But I did like a special one for the girl I had a crush on. The girl I liked. It wasn't that special, but it was somewhat special. Hey, guys, see you. Oh, hello. Hey. It's also Ash Wednesday. Shout out to the Catholics, the Lutherans who do that, the whoever else. Episcopalians. I heard Tucker made fun of himself as being an Episcopalian. Because Episcopalians are not real. Hey, you simp. The Episcopalians are not real Christians. They're kind of liberal and soft and hippie-ish or something. Those back east New England people. But happy Ash Wednesday. No mention of Ash Wednesday from far-left extremist anti-Christian commie nonsense network, nor... nor... The far-left female-run outlet, The Skim. What's going on? Who's your bear? No, I did not use any glitter on my Valentine's cards that I gave out. They were peanuts. It was like Snoopy, Charlie Brown, Lucy, all those, you know, the Charles Schultz guy cartoon. But that was, it was fun. It was nice. Valentine's Day. So what are we going to talk about today, guys? Just going to have a loosey-goosey Hake show. I'll correct the pronunciation of Kelce or Kelce. I will settle it once and for all. I have, Dana White's done with podcasts. I don't have the clip for you, but I'm just going to tell you a little bit about it. There's another person going to start up a new whole podcast. That attention-seeking Meghan Markle gal, ego-driven gal. She's left Spotify, home of Joe Rogan. She couldn't compete with Joe Rogan, who is my competitor. Hake is on Spotify, though. I'm not canceling my Spotify, even though they have deleted some of my episodes over the years. Can you believe it? They've deleted some of my episodes. What do they think they are? YouTube? Give me a break. But anyway, guys. Let's get right on with the show!
1, 2, 3, 4. Oh, it's the Hake Report. The Hake Report. La, la, la. Oh, it's the Hake Report. The Hake Report. La, la, la.
Hey, guys!
Oh, it's the Hake Report. The Hake Report. La, la, la.
So, how you guys doing? I'm fine. JLP was commenting, what are you going to tell them you're wearing today, Hake? And I said, just a plain old shirt. It's a nice sort of brick red. What did you call it? Burnt orange red t-shirt? Nice. And it's a medium, but it doesn't look too tiny. It's like borderline, but just... perfect. Just right. I don't know. Nowadays, they wear... it was kind of like back in the 90s. I used to wear size large, and then I started wearing size medium after college. But all throughout, from 7th grade all the way through college, I wore size large. Well, maybe in college, I started wearing some mediums sometimes. What a mess. because it was in to wear baggy clothes. Crazy. And now it's coming back. I mean, it is nice to be comfortable. Anyway, I don't want to get too far off on that. But, yeah, I won't tell you where I bought it. I won't tell you where I bought this shirt, but it would cost me only like 12 bucks or less. And I say only as if that's not that much money. Back in the day, that used to be plenty of money. Give me a break. Money is just... A nickel is not worth a dime anymore. Burnt sienna. Nice. How do you know that's... come on, man. I'm excited about the music that I'm going to be playing for you guys. It's Work Hard Wednesday. It's also Stephen Wiley Wednesday. Oh, yes. Black History Month. The first Christian rapper, allegedly. But to correct the record, guys, this is... I say it's important. This is important. It's Kelce. It's not Kelce. It is Kelce, only because everybody was calling it Kelce. But originally, it was Kelce. Hat tip to Big Bump for the tips. He gave me this information way back in September of 2023. And in January of 2024, Kelce's father... What's that guy's name? Travis? Is it Travis Kelce? Something Kelce? Andy Kelce? Huh? I don't know. Something Kelce. The one who, whose girlfriend's with Taylor Swift, speaking of Valentine's Day. I think they look great together, by the way, on the outside. On the inside, not so much. I don't like the PDAs. That doesn't look that good on the outside either. Her kissing them at the game on camera. Psh, you woman. He's like 33 years old or something like that. Such a disappointment, Taylor Swift. That's how it all goes, though. Everybody's a disappointment. Are your parents, are your children a disappointment? I chuckle while I ask, but it's somewhat of a serious question. Is it Steve Kelce? You call him Steve Kelce. Whatever his name is. Travis. Travis and Jason Kelce. Even Travis and Jason's mom, Donna, got it wrong. So, this is from Big Bump, and Big Bump is a pretty reliable source. You know, take everything you ever hear with a grain of salt. From Hake, Big Bump, just know for yourself, right? But Kelce's father, Perg Big Bump, was too weak to correct people on the pronunciation of their last name. It's actually pronounced Kelce, K-E-L-S-S, and not Kel hyphen C-S-E-E. No, it's Kelce. And he shared a few months later an Instagram reel from The Sun. I'll even post it in the chat if you guys don't believe me. The far-left foreign outlet, The Sun, NFL fans are only just realizing how to pronounce Kelce. Or Kelce, K-E-L-C-E, with even Travis and Jason's mom, Donna, getting it wrong. Hashtag NFL. Hashtag Kelce. Hashtag Travis Kelce. Hashtag Jason. Who's going to look up hashtag Jason? That doesn't make any sense. They're going to get the guy who killed people. And hashtag Donna Kelce. So I call him Kelce, not Kelce. Joel Friday barged into the room the other day. Correcting me on Mahomes, it's Mahomes, and Kelce, it's not Kelce. Egg on Joel's face. He got embarrassed. No, but either one is right, actually, because the father, according to this story, I think he was like 20 years old. I could be butchering the story, but I think the father, Travis and Jason, Kelce's father, I never said Mahomes. What the? He said Mahomes. Something like that. Mahomes. But I called it what Mahomes. I still call it Mahomes. Mahomes. The father got tired of correcting people. And so he just took Kelce. He started pronouncing it Kelce. I don't think he legally changed the pronunciation. I just think he just accepted it and started calling it that. Reminds me a lot. Okay, so he got tired of correcting people. It reminds me a lot of that one woman, that do-gooder woman, legend, Chrissy Legend. Chrissy Teigen. It's Chrissy Teigen, I think. Not Teigen. I wanted to call it Teigen because it sounds E before I, right? Chrissy Teigen, but it's actually pronounced Chrissy Teigen, according to her mother. And she knows it, but other people pronounce it Teigen or whatever, I guess. Chrissy Teigen. You guys know John Legend's wife. A couple of liberals. And she's too much of a people pleaser to correct them on the pronunciation. Wow. Wow. She used to be quite mildly pretty, mildly attractive. I mean, she still probably is, right? I don't know. She's married. Chrissy, how am I a model? Teigen. Because she's ambiguous, too. You know, that Asian sort of look. She looks kind of Asian. A model. But she, too weak. Liberals. Is Travis Kelce a liberal? He is getting with a liberal female. I do think they look good together, though. I agree with Pearl. I saw Pearl say, I think they're good for each other. I don't know if they're good for each other, but they look like a great couple. She looks like it's skinny cheerleader gal, singer gal, and he looks like a football player jock that they would be together. Except they're in their 30s. What a mess. Hake. I've been called so many different things, but it's not all one way. Sometimes it was Hake, James Hake. Sometimes it would be the starting guy who shoot the starter gun for a race. He once called me Hacker. Hacker, hockey brush. What a mess. Kelce is definitely a commie, says Cash Daily. Shout out to Cash Daily. So, that's your update on the correct pronunciation, supposedly correct pronunciation. Both are correct, in my opinion. If you want to be like Hake about it, you harken back to the old days and call him what it's supposed to be, Kelce. If you want to be with the people, the communists, call them Kelce. That's the people. Okay. This was interesting. So, I was perusing Twitter this morning, and I saw this bald guy who looked sort of like Joe Rogan, my competitor, but he's a little bit thicker and older looking, I guess. Maybe not even older. And I'm like, oh yeah, that's Dana White. Also from the UFC. He's the founder or the big man at the UFC. Big man. It's also the name of a song coming up from Stephen Wiley. And he's looking at this guy, introducing him. This male named Howie Mandel. I don't think he's a Christian. I don't think he is. He might even be a liberal. Sounds kind of like a liberal. And this guy is introducing Dana White for his podcast. They're sitting down like this at a table with their long arm holding the mics at the table, podcast, introducing Dana White. Oh, he's a philosopher, extraordinary. I'm jealous of you. This is all just kissing up to him. Kissing up. A kiss up. And it was, made me want to spit. Two. And apparently it made, I don't know if this is why, but apparently it made Dana White, a man named Dana. It's, both people can be called that, men and women. It made him sick too. It made him sick too. He's all, you know what? And he pushes the mic over. After he says this, I'm so tired of doing podcasts. I'm so F-wording sick of this. You're not in the same league as Joe Rogan, Hake. Irregardless, HP3, he is my competitor. And he is bald. Hake has hair somewhat like Joe Rogan used to have hair. I'm catching up to Joe Rogan. So let me do the baby league, and then let me get in the big league. But he's like, I'm so sick of this. I'm done with podcasts forever. And so he pushes the mic away and gets up and takes off his headphones and just walks out of the room. And there's this Howie Mandel, sort of an older guy, maybe 50s or 60s or maybe even 70s, bald-headed too. For some reason, I think of a Howie as having red hair, but I don't know if this guy ever had hair or red hair or what. And he's just stunned, sitting there. And you see, like, I think there's a woman in the room who's also has a mic for some reason. And there's a long-haired, supposedly white man also in the room off to the side with a silly look on his face. And, and it's just awkward for like a moment, a few moments maybe, depending on how long you want to count a moment as being. It might have been the kissing up. I do not know. It could have been, it could have felt like a setup. Oh, I just kiss up to how great he is and then just go in about, ooh, so, Bud Light. You're still taking Bud Light money, and you're giving a long leash to these free speech people, because Dana White has allowed his people, his fighters, the fighters in his league, to speak their mind. Will you show the clip, Hake? Now I want to watch. No, I do not. I cannot show the clip. Maybe ask American Anchor Baby to show it for you, maybe, or Joel Friday TV. Who doesn't take Bud Light money? Exactly. Me, of course, is Cash Daily. Oh, yeah. Me neither, because I have principles. It was quite interesting. And he's... I don't know if I agree with the way he did it, but it's fine, whatever. That's him. It doesn't even matter whether I agree or not. And I'm not really, based on what I saw, sympathetic that much to Howie Mandel. Yeah, I'm pretty sure that guy's not a Christian. Doesn't even seem like a normal white. Nice. Nice. So, Dana White is kind of like this middle of the road running this business and supporting Trump, I think. Doing his thing. Right on, Dana White. We wish you well. He's, you know, hit and miss. Just like anybody is hit and miss. You could even call President Trump hit and miss. Sort of. President Trump. So nice. Just gushing. His team was stunned. His team was stunned. That's cool. Speaking of podcasts... You know who has who quit Spotify and now she's going onto some lame-o website thing is Harry's wife. Is he an ex-prince? Ex-Prince Harry? What is this? According to both the far-left female-run outlet The Skim and Commie Nonsense Network, they both disregard what today is for many Christians, Ash Wednesday. It's just a tradition, right? This Ash Wednesday thing. They disregard that, but they both tell us about Meghan Markle. Meghan Markle. Is Prince Harry no longer a prince? He's forsaken his duties? Something like that? The Commie Nonsense Network and the far-left females at The Skim report, who's turning lemons into lemonada? 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 Lemon nothing. Because nada means nothing in Spanish. Meghan Markle! And this evil Commie Nonsense Network calls her the Duchess of Sussex. Is she still a duchess, or did she forsake her duties and so she's stripped of the title? They should strip her of the title and sack her. Sack doesn't mean tackle in English. It means fire. Fire her. For Meghan Markle's yet-to-be-announced podcast launching on Lemonada Media. Well, is that a loss for Spotify? Because she used to be on Spotify, Harry and Meghan, I think. Or does anybody listen to the Duchess of Sussex? Is she Hake's competitoress? Competitress? It was a couple's thing. Harry and Meghan. Harry looking like a simp. With that mixed race gal, liberal, so-called American gal. Is she now on her own? She's striking out on her own? On this podcast thing, CNN says Lemonada Media is home to a bunch of women. Julia Louis-Dreyfus. Julia Louis-Dreyfus's podcast. Did you know that she had a podcast? Isn't that gal from, she's the sort of, I kind of liked her in, was she in Seinfeld? That's who that is, I think. Seinfeld, the old TV show. Wiser Than Me with Julia Louis-Dreyfus, Louis-Dreyfus. And she's also, Lemonada Media also has choice words with Samantha Bee. I happen to know a little bit about Samantha Bee. I confuse her with some of these other liberal, unchristian, supposedly blonde, slightly older females, women. I think of her as this vulgar comedian, woman, liberal, anti-Trump, Samantha Bee. James, calling it the far-left female-run outlet, The Skim, doesn't fool anyone into thinking you don't support it. I do not pay a dime to The Skim, nor have I ever even heard of Lemonada Media. I barely know who these women are. But after stepping down, listen to this, after stepping down as senior royals and moving into the United States in 2020, they just abandoned England. Of course, they would only have made things worse there. Harry and Meghan secured numerous media deals, including with Spotify and far-left Netflix. Netflix is evil. You guys pay for Netflix? The Netflix CEO and his wife supported George Gascon, the Black Lives Matter supported, George Soros supported Los Angeles DA, who does not prosecute crime, basically. So that's evil Netflix. They're Black Lives Matter degenerates. and also their stuff is evil, but I don't know. They have some good stuff out on there. Right? The streaming home of the docuseries. Oh, okay. It's a docuseries, Harry and Meghan, chronicled their courtship. Their relationship with the media and their decision to leave royal life. So they left royal life. So why are they still called Duchess of Sussex and Prince Harry? What's Harry's last name anyway? The couple, I forget what it was. I think that he has a last name. The couple's multi-year partnership ended with Spotify in June of last year, 2023. Archwell and Spotify said to CNN both companies had mutually agreed to part ways and proud of the series they made together. Well, that's cute. That's cute. I have pictures of this gal. It just makes me want to spit seeing this couple. Because Harry's somewhat, you know, he's almost borderline Chad. He could be a Chad. But no, he was raised lame. And took his family into hell by getting with this woman. Well, the family's already in hell. But this woman kind of exposed... Oh, it's under Hake News. It's in the Hake News section, Hassan. Meghan Markle, Prince Harry. Ugh, AP. I mean, she's pretty. She's mildly attractive. But she's not an English woman. She's mixed. She doesn't even seem black. She's supposedly part black. She does not seem black to me. She looks like, I don't know, Latina or something. I don't even think she has any Latin blood in her. But that's... Okay, so all ego, all looking at each other, posing for the cameras. His suit's all stylish. Okay, just kind of cycle through all these photos if you can there. Look! PDA! Public display of affection. Looks like they're kissing. We see the back of her head. We see part of the front of his head. Don't do that. That's desperation. They're trying to hold on to this phony feeling. Evil. Next. I should have censored that. See, look, doesn't he look almost like a Chad? His hair is a different color of red than mine. His hair is more orange than mine. Light red. That's because I'm more Scottish and he's more English, I think. I'm making that up. Terrible. Look at that! That's terrible. Look how white his hand is. And then her hands, did they lighten it to make her look whiter? I'm wondering if they lightened her hands. Or if she's been staying out of the sun and looks more pale. Because she's barely darker than him in this picture. But he's like light, bluish white. Bluish. The Black Hebrew Israelites would call him pink. Forget you, Black Hebrew Israelites. No, don't forget you. We love you, Black Hebrew Israelites, if we love anybody. But look, her hand is all on his hand, showing off her wedding ring. These women, when their wedding rings. You ladies, get over this wedding stuff. How embarrassing. All posed, all conspicuous. I blame the photographer in part, but... And his face is, her head is up against his face, by the way. That's not right. Ladies, relax. That's not life. Nowadays, people are getting together all old, if at all, if ever, and... I encourage both the ladies and the gents not to think of that as an L, as taking an L, a loss, in to contradict one of my callers in recent weeks, Aaron of Air and Sea, of Air and Sea. That's not an L not to get married. Would Harry be less obviously a loser were he not with this woman? The fact is, I say, of course we don't know, but I say yes, he would be less of a loser were he not to be less obviously anyway, a loser, less exposed as a lame-o simp were he not with that woman. And she's pretty, but first of all, it's interracial and you're a royal white Anglo. Man, But that's not even, well, I don't know, it's all kinds of wrong things with it. She's a liberal, he's going liberal with her. He's all flaunting about, gallivanting about, whatever that word is, with her forsaking his royal, so-called royal duties, whatever that means. The royals are dumb, liberal, and evil anyway, but this woman is taking it even worse. So corrupt. It's just really a sign of, it's a personification of what's happened to so many, too many of us whites, of the whites. Look, his hair is a little bit thinning too. This is from like 2018. Some of these pictures are 2017. She looks like she's, rubbing elbows with the people. Arrogant woman. She was like a no-name actress thing in the United States. And then she went over and stole his weak, tender, Satan-possessed heart. Terrible. Ladies. Gentlemen. Stop it. Look, she's even... Last one. She's even face-palming over him. She's embarrassed by him in this picture. He's sitting on stage looking all boyish. He has one of his hands underneath his thighs. All boyish and charming and goofy. And she's embarrassed. No, I don't know if she's embarrassed by him. Hake is just reading into the picture, but they're on a stage on this panel discussion. How embarrassing. How embarrassing. Okay, thank you, Hassan. It makes me wonder, since it is Valentine's Day, you know, I said earlier this hour that Taylor Swift, Travis Kelce, yes, it is Kelce. The dad just got frustrated with everybody calling it Kelce, so he said, okay, fine, it's Kelce. In other words, he was weak. No wonder Travis... Whatever. Yeah, they look good together, but remember Travis accosted his coach, that supposedly legendary coach Andy Reid, whatever the guy's name is, in the Super Bowl? I'm chuckling at the chat. He's all over-aggressive. Is he trying to perform and all angry at his girlfriend? And so he shoves his coach because he can't shove his girlfriend. I wonder, it's total speculation. I don't know. But all that kissing in public and, hey, I think that she brought the numbers for those people watching this so-called Super Bowl. Super lame bull. But they flashed to her because, you know, she's an entertainer and she's giving facial expressions to different things, I guess. I don't know. I didn't watch a lick of it, like I said. Hake knows nothing but everything at the same time, indeed. I differ with some of you guys who make the claim that she was sleeping around because you don't know that she did. One thing, she intercepted Travis. One thing to Taylor Swift's credit, I think, maybe, possibly. Not sure, haven't kept up with her. She doesn't sing this vulgar stuff that much. Yeah, she's like all into relationships and breakups, right? But to my knowledge, she never... sang this W.A. blank song, right? She never sang that song, did she? No, she did not, to my knowledge. She's just halfway wholesome. Okay, one-third of the way wholesome. She sort of dresses a little skimpy, quite skimpy on the stage. I had to censor pictures of her before on here. So she doesn't brag about sleeping around, so you don't know that she's slept around. Just because she's had a bunch of different boyfriends, you don't know. You don't know. All you people, you sick people, talking about her like she's this ut slay. W.A. Blank, which I don't think I've ever heard, is way more of a banger than any Taylor Swift song. So says Big Mitch 909. I beg to differ, man. I've heard many Swift songs. Primarily on the Jesse Lee Peterson show 10, 15 years ago. Okay? And those are some catchy songs. One day I'll be living in a big old city, and all you're ever gonna be is mean. Why you gotta be so mean? That's way better than any W.A. Blank. I say. You belong with me. Didn't she sing some song about her being in a... She's got something. I have sneakers. She's in the cheerleading squad. I'm in the bleachers. But you belong with me. She got that dude finally after 20-some years. It's good. She's not terrible. The music is nice. Can we never revisit that? Anyway, yeah, I like the early albums. I don't even know the albums. I just know the hits that were played on the Jesse Lee Peterson show. And one of my country music fan Asian friends first introduced me to her songs, not her personally. But yeah, whatever, we wish them well. That was not about lesbians. No, she was talking about a football player, jock, whom she liked, and the jock was with the cheerleader, but the jock belonged with her. I don't think she's sung any lesbian songs. This is not ex-Christian singer Katy Perry, who used to be Katie Hudson and put out a Christian album, and now she's singing evil songs. And had a falling out with Taylor Swift. Whose side are you on with that? Neither. They're both evil. They're all evil. I'm with Kanye West. No, but I'm pulling for Taylor Swift. I think that they could repent. Whatever. Yeah, a hater's gonna hate. Exactly. That one's a little bit later. That's when she went into like pop music. But it's good. It's still good. And she writes those songs. It's really good, I heard. Just ask even American Anchor Baby knows. Don't say that, Terry. Is that true? I don't want to know that. Talking about that stuff. Honestly, guys and gals, it's degenerate to repeat what the evil do in darkness, right? And Kanye is evil too. Yeah, yes. Hit and miss. I'm pulling for Kanye. We wish all of these people well, right? No, it's not music break. But anyway, the point is, it's not the, life is more than this dumb, evil, romance stuff. It's right now. It's you guys in the chat, although maybe you guys aren't really living, some of you. It's doing your work. It's washing your car. It's whatever you're up to. That's life now. You don't revolve around some other person. All right. So, yes, I didn't watch the so-called Super Bowl. I didn't watch it. Well, everyone, say the far-left females at the Skim, was watching the Super Bowl LVIII, which is 58, I think, on Sunday night, more than 123.4 million viewers tuned in to watch the Kansas City Chiefs barely beat the San Francisco 49ers. Shout out to the 49ers. Making it the most watched Super Bowl in U.S. history. But we're also the most populous country that we've ever been, right? I think so. The game only comes second in viewership to the 1969 moon landing, which was real. Maybe. I think so, yes. In an era in which TV networks are looking for new ways to adapt to the media landscape, you know, all these layoffs. Has Netflix laid anybody off? Paramount Pictures did some layoffs. All these tech groups are doing layoffs. The evil Super Bowl, Super Lame Bowl, has consistently been able to draw millions of viewers every year. I used to think that it was the most watched thing, and then somebody said, no, actually, the World Cup is. I'm like, whoever heard of the World Cup? I was in high school. I was like a sophomore in high school. Whoever heard of the World Cup? Well, it happens. When's the World Cup? Like every 4 years or something? Yes, that's watched more than the Super Bowl or the Olympics or anything, I guess. The World Cup, where the different countries' teams play against each other in soccer. Futbol, not American football. Not clear if the drama of the game going into overtime or the Taylor Swift Travis Kelce, not Kelsey, relationship. It can be Kelsey if you want. Or just the American love, false, phony love for that sport is behind the surge. Nice. I think that it was the Taylor Swift thing. Give credit where it's due. Travis, is he good? I don't know. But stay with that woman, because you're bringing in the viewership. Every 4 years, the World Cup brings people together. Don't people kill one another over soccer, over football? I think people kill one another over soccer. So don't tell me that soccer brings people together. And also, soccer's FIFA is whatever, something, 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 soccer league, whatever. They're trying to get rid of racism. So they're also divisive because they're smearing the whites for being normal, whereas everybody else gets to be normal. But the whites, except for not the whites, because racism is only applied against whites, right? Everybody else gets to be racist, but not the whites. You don't get to be for the whites. Isn't it true that the whites are 10% of the world? Somebody said that. More than one person has said that. I don't know if it's true. Whites, a tiny minority, but I guess they're running the show in different countries, supposedly, or they were, not me. And they surrendered it to other people who were even a smaller minority. And then they get all these majority people to flood into the white countries, and now it's a mess. It's terrible. Not good. I've never met a good Travis, says Seesaw. So judgmental. Anyway, that's enough of that pop culture mess. Let's talk about real life. As if I know anything about real life. Inflation. I know nothing about inflation, but they say that it's happening. The far left extremist labor department, according to the far-left female-run outlet, The Skim, reported that the overall, whatever this is, CPI, Consumer Price Index, rose 3.1% in January from a year earlier. I was talking about how a nickel is not worth a dime anymore. A nickel used to be, a nickel in the old days used to buy you candy and gasoline and everything. Now it doesn't even buy a dime. From January, a year earlier. That's a bit more than analysts' expectations of 2.9%. They expected it to be bad. It's even worse, supposedly. I guess these things mean bad thing. Mean something bad. It means your money's cheaper. I mean, it's, yeah, your money's cheaper. It's not worth as much. They're cheapening money in so many different ways. It's ridiculous. Meanwhile, the U.S. stock market had its worst day in nearly a year as the Dow dropped more than 700 points at its low. The CPI, Consumer Price Index, whatever that is, report had investors worried it could be a bit longer before the evil Federal Reserve starts cutting interest rates. What a mess. You know, I had this know-it-all caller who says that the Fed controls the economy because they control, what are they calling? Interest rates. Interest rates, you make a loan, and then you have to pay, and then that person has to pay you interest on that loan, and they control those interest rates, right? Something like that? I don't know. But if you're not in debt, you're not controlled by that because you make your own money. Your economy is fine, whatever the case. Your own personal economy should be fine, whatever the case. Save your money. I know that they say that the dollar is going to crash. People say that. It might. I don't know. One does not know the future. Because the dollar is artificially propped up as this big valuable thing, but they're cheapening it in so many different ways. I don't care. Get rid of minimum wage. Get rid of all these handouts that they're just giving away money to these people. Aren't they giving away money to illegals? And women and welfare. Get rid of all that stuff. Unemployment. Fire a bunch of the, none of this stuff is going to happen. So just save your money. Live wisely. Work. And you'll be valuable. You'll be valuable and you won't be wanting. You will not find yourself wanting. Hopefully. We'll see what happens. It would be nice if Trump got in and then people could be doing fine again, because when things are rough, when things are rougher, there's more incentive. There's more. It's not that people are desperate. The thieves are not desperate. They're not stealing because they're hungry. They're not stealing because they need money. They're stealing because it's more profitable to steal. It becomes more and more profitable to steal the more the evil people, the liberals, run the country, the economy into the ground. The more they allow the crime, the more crime happens. The more they allow the crime, the more desperate the businesses are because they can't just make money the normal way, the more honest way, because these dishonest people are making it worse. They call it a tax when there's theft. And it's not a normal tax. It is these businesses raising prices to account for all the theft. The thieves are stealing merchandise from people, from businesses. Businesses are raising up prices so that you honest people, I'm pointing to you guys like you're so honest, pay more and don't steal. Don't steal, kids. I remember one time I had the thought to steal when I was a little kid at the newsstand in Arcadia. I remember doing it. I didn't steal, but I had the thought to do it. I'm like, I could easily steal that pack of gum. Those two packs of gum, I could steal that. But I didn't. I think it's probably a good thing that I did not cross that line. Because then it's not a temptation to steal. If you never cross the line, it's not so easy to cross, to keep on crossing that line. But if you do cross the line, it's kind of like the S word, sex. Since once you've crossed that line, you keep on wanting to cross that line. But if you've never had it, it's easier not to cross it. Same thing with everything. But they raise the prices on the honest people. That's part of what's raising up prices, by the way, people. Hake would steal. I didn't say I would or wouldn't. I just said I did not end up stealing. Hake almost stole once. It's crazy, huh? I see these pictures of these black females robbing a store, like a clothing store, in broad daylight, shamelessly, not even wearing masks that I could tell. I don't know. I couldn't really see their faces, but, you know, it's kind of dark, you know. In the city of Orange, in Orange County, California, in the city of Orange. At the outlets or something like that. The outlets are already pretty cheap, supposed to be. Cost versus effect is all it is, Hake. Those elevated prices are the cost affected by the theft. A weird punishment to those who do not steal. Yep. Thank you, Lin Yen Chin. I will get to your super chats, guys. Let me get to a call here, guys. 888-775-3773. Mr. Pink in California. How you doing?
What's up, brother? Hey. I'm doing all right.
Right on.
Yeah, yeah. You know, we're talking about the rise in prices and all that mess. You saw that stupid Super Bowl ad with Joe Biden, right?
No, I haven't seen any Super Bowl ads. I have not seen even one.
Good.
Yeah.
Good. Don't worry about that. Okay.
Are you talking about that one where he...
You see it independently? He's talking about shrinkflation?
Shrinkflation?
Yeah, he's sitting there in his little old man chair, like, and he's talking about how I like to have snacks for the Super Bowl. And then he's sitting there complaining about how prices have gone up on snacks. And he's sitting there complaining about, he's like, oh, my favorite thing's ice cream. And now they made the ice cream container smaller. And then they charge
yeah.
the same price.
True.
And I'm like, bruh, what are you doing? That's your fault, man.
Yep. Indeed.
He's sitting there like acting like he didn't do nothing. Or like his whole economic policies aren't, you know, a direct result of that.
Right. I know.
But, you know, I don't want to like plug another show on your show, but I mean, Fleckus was discussing this yesterday. He's like, aren't you kind of giving yourself away, dummy?
Like, true. Yep.
It's just crazy to me.
It is.
It's like, can't stop talking about ice cream, but then you can't like not be a hypocrite right in front of everybody. On, I don't know. His brainwashing techniques are really kind of lacking. Because he did that same thing the other day where he just like bold-faced lies straight to everybody. And it was like, well, you know, you can blame the MAGA Republicans and Trump for the border problem. Like, what?
How? How did he figure?
Straight out, straight face, with no hesitation, straight face was like, it's because they didn't pass this, you know.
Oh, yeah, because we didn't want that phony border bill. Like they're really ever going to enforce the border with a bill. They've
like,
done this over and over and over again. They tricked Ronald Reagan into giving amnesty because in exchange for so-called border security. And of course they didn't follow through with it. They didn't give any border security. They just got the amnesty. They never, ever going to get this stuff under control because they don't do what's right.
It's
I don't
really
even have to read the bill to know this.
Yeah, it's like the people he's appealing to and his base, it must just be the people that can't think past like 30 seconds like a goldfish.
Yeah.
You know, it's like really bad. It's like,
well,
oh, you know, we're thinking of it. Only in the past year has this been a problem. So, you know, it's all the Republicans for not passing this one bill. Like, you haven't seen the numbers that have increased, like, the number of encounters under Trump were like in the low, like maybe it was like 100,000-200,000, and now it's like a million and stuff.
Wow.
What is that?
It's bad. You know,
this is like bold face straight at you, like lie, right?
Yeah.
I think
feel like the Obama, Biden, all these liars, the Democrat liars specifically, and some of the rhinos too. The rhinos can trick you too. But the they are almost like trolling you with their lies, where they're pretending like they're doing it, and they make a big joke out of it. Even when this is really
serious, they know
serious.
They can get away with it because people are really getting like dumber and dumber.
Right.
You know,
it's affecting people's lives for the worse. But the people are so dumb they don't know. Yeah,
I was talking about this with my coworker earlier. About okay, you remember when we were growing up, what the grade scale was in high school? Okay.
What?
It's different now. like the grade scale, like to graduate high school.
Oh yeah,
grades. Okay,
they call it grade inflation.
Me and my coworker were talking about this, and she wasn't aware. I was like explaining to her when I was in high school, a 93 to 100 was an A. A 92 to 85 was a B.
A minus. Right? Well, they had A minus too, right?
Yeah, but that's like the low end of like 94 or 93.
Okay.
Right. Then 93 to 85 was B. 85 to 77 was C. 77 to 70 was a D, and then below that you failed.
Wow, right? I didn't know that.
Now, well, that's what it was when I grew up.
Because when I grew up, it was 70s is a C, 80s is a B, 90s is a A minus to A, and then 100 is A plus.
Where'd you grow up?
L.A. County.
Okay, well, then maybe it's been like that way in California the whole time. Maybe I'm crazy, because when I grew up in North Carolina, the standards must have been like way higher.
Okay.
It's like, now it's like 60 to 70 is a D.
Wow.
And I'm like, how is that passing? How can you get only half of stuff right?
Yeah.
So now it's, that's crazy to me, because that's not the way it was when I grew up in North Carolina.
That's
like
funny.
70 or above was a D, right?
Yeah.
Like 70 to 77, and then below that, it's like, how can you, like, let people pass by knowing, like, half the stuff?
Right.
And then it's not getting worse where they're saying that you don't have to read and have to do basic math to get out of high school. And then, like, I was just, like, I was venting to her about this, because this girl that closes for us, she can't, like, count the drawer to, like, $200. Like,
wow.
To save her life. Like, you know, she write on the envelope, the expected deposit for the cash was 14, right? And then she put in, but actual was 15.25, but then the drawer was short $1.25. And I'm like, bro.
Terrible.
Yeah, it's just like, what? That brings in that Bill Engvall, you can't fix stupid stuff.
Yeah.
Anyway, like you said, is directly affecting our lives, because now, like, the standards are so low that, you know, once again, people are expecting something for nothing now. And I just wanted to, like, make a little comment. I took my girl out for a little Valentine's date last night, because we're going to go to church tonight, so I wouldn't have time for all that today.
Is this the older one?
Yeah.
All right.
Well, yes. You know, we're getting along just fine, but we go into this Italian restaurant, right? And, like Jesse talks about this all the time, customer service standards are just gone.
Yeah.
We walked in the door to this nice, fancy Italian restaurant, and the guy that's supposed to seat us, the, maitre d' or whatever they call it.
Burger King?
He's standing at the front. Nah, it was like a nice Italian restaurant. It had some fancy Italian name.
Yes.
We walked in, and he looked at us, and he went, yeah.
What?
He didn't say, yeah. I was like, can we have a table?
Right.
Like, what? Are you seriously?
Was it loud?
Say,
and
hey,
was
how
it loud?
Hey, how are you? No, there was no one in there.
Oh, wow.
There was like one table seated, and there was like a whole thing open, right?
Yeah.
And he looks at us and goes, yeah? I'm like,
maybe that's Italian for something.
How are you doing today? It's almost Valentine's Day. Can we get you a nice table or something? You know?
Maybe he was asking for you. He was waiting for you to say how many or something like that.
I don't know, but he just like, but there was no like actual question or greeting. It was just, yeah.
Was he Italian?
Like we offended him by walking in.
Yeah.
And then he seated us, passed us off to another waiter. That waiter looked at us like he's confused, even though there's nobody in the building. And he looked at us and went, do you have like a reservation? And I was like, no, is that a problem? What is going on here? Like, there's no one in here.
Yeah.
And he's like, no. And then he barely took our order. And then, you know, I said, I can mark it. I said, thank you to this dude. Thank you, sir, to this dude, like 5 times. Not one single you're welcome the whole time.
Uh-huh.
But I said, thank you, sir. And he would just turn his back and walk the other way.
Huh.
And I'm like, word. Okay. So I went on to Mr. Pink. No tip for you.
Wow.
No. I just like, and then like the rest of the time, they were just kind of like walking by our table, like side eyeing us and stuff. And it's like, I looked at him. I was like, hey, you know, I just want you to know that the customer service here has been pretty rude this entire time. And I'm like pretty disappointed. And he looked at it and it wasn't like, oh, I'm sorry. He looked at it and was like, what's rude?
Really? He said that?
Yeah. He's like, what's rude?
So are these?
And I'm like, bro, I'm not even going to answer that question. Just we're going to order our food and be on our way.
Wow.
And he still like wanted to like stare at me like he had a problem. I'm like, bro, we're not inconveniencing you. This is your job to serve us.
Maybe you should have walked out at that point. If it was that
bad.
We
wanted to eat. You know, we wanted to eat, and the food was definitely subpar. Well, I definitely like Google reviewed that and was like, bro, that was just that's just a sad state of affairs when you go to.
Did
a
you
nice
guys
Italian
look funny
restaurant.
Or something?
No, we were like, you know, we had a button-up shirt, and she had a nice dress on, and we were like.
And she
know,
doesn't.
Again,
she, and she's not obviously.
In that building.
And she's not obviously like looking older than you, right?
No,
Italians no. like that stuff anyway, don't they? Were they were these yeah. people Italians? These workers?
Yeah. No. No. That was like it was an Italian restaurant, and all the waiters that we had were Hispanic.
Okay. That's what I figured.
<I'm> like, but it's just like, it, like they just got me from the beginning with the yeah, like we offended them
yeah.
by walking in. I was like, seriously, all right, we're already off on a bad note, and then it just got like went downhill from there. I was like, are you serious?
You
like,
should have followed
really
that. You should have followed that hint because you got the bad impression right away, and just gone somewhere else.
Yeah, you got a good
Maybe.
Point there.
Yeah,
man. Yeah, I was just like, wow, is it literally at this point where they're just expecting, you know, a tip from you by, like, being a total stooge? Like, are you serious? Like, is that real?
Normally, where I am, the Mexicans are nice.
Yeah, I mean, maybe it's just a one-off. Maybe this place is just, like, entitled or, you know, I don't know. But it was like, I've never been in a situation where it was like, you walk in and you're already like on the spot, like we're doing something wrong. That was just the weirdest feeling.
Yeah, that is strange.
It's like customer service is just completely out the window. Yeah,
it is anyway. Pretty bad. There's often times little hints of a bad attitude, and people are and the customers are oftentimes weak or angry or kissing up or overly people-pleasing, so
yeah.
it's
that whole tip automatically culture too that
true.
Me and Nick were talking about the other day.
Yeah.
That whole tip automatically. It's like it's that's also going to lower the standards of the service you get because the people are just going to be expecting it without feeling like they have to do anything.
Right. Yeah.
You know.
That is
like I go out of my way, even though people are going to tip me regardless, probably I go out of my way when I'm working over here to like tell people all the discounts they can get.
Right.
Make sure we greet them nicely. Do all that stuff. Whether they're like in a
you're about my age, right? Aren't you in your 40s, 30s?
I'm 36.
OK. Doxed.
Yeah. So close. You know, I guess it's like I just come from an era where. And also, I'm from North Carolina, where Southern hospitality is, like, not lost on people.
Right. The South is hospitable.
You know, with, like, when you come in, we're going to be like, how are you doing today? What can we get for you?
Right.
You know, it's going to be all that. Not freaking, yeah.
Right.
I was like,
I remember
yeah?
I got yelled at by my coach one time because I'm like, to the McDonald's person, the McDonald's person taking my order said something. And I used to hate going to order from fast food places because I'm so picky and I don't know what to get. I
yeah.
wasn't used to getting it. And so I was like, huh? I said, huh? And my coach was like, hey, it's supposed to be, excuse me. It's supposed
yeah,
to be,
correct.
Excuse me? Not, huh?
If you can, huh, you can hear.
Right. But I didn't mean anything rude. I was just saying, huh?
Yeah, but still,
that's
you know,
funny.
It's just so crazy to me.
Right.
Like, people are just so entitled nowadays.
It's
especially
true, man.
In, like, richer, privileged areas. They're just expecting something for nothing. It's that same thing with, like, lowering the standards in school.
I think it's partly the
high school.
Partly the evil going around. People are more stressed.
Yeah.
It's not Happy Jack's economy like we have, like we had under Trump until the China virus.
Right.
Everybody had, the liberals took the excuse to shut down the economy under the China virus, but
yeah,
it's partly that. It's partly emotions, and emotions are encouraged among people. So
yeah, they have less money to throw around, that's for sure.
Yeah, so
thing.
There's all this division and evil.
Mm-hmm.
It's a wave of evil going around, so just be patient with people.
Yeah, that's for sure. You know, it gives you a moment to look within.
Yeah.
And, you know, you hit me with that recently, and Joel hit me with that yesterday on the chat, because I was kind of, like, criticizing people who were criticizing others, and all that mess. And nice. I just want to throw it out there. I won't be able to call in to Joelle for the next couple of days because I ain't got coverage here at work.
Oh, okay.
But I just want you to extend the message through you to him that, you know, he's right. I need to have eyes on myself and not be judging others. And he's, you know, I was poking fun at him, and I think he took it a little harsh. And so I just want to extend my, you know, well wishes to Joelle. You know, much love, bud.
Nice. Right on, man. Appreciate it, Mr. Pink. Take care.
All right. Hey, enjoy the music.
All right. Bye. Yes, indeed. It's time for some music, guys. It's Starfire 59, Work Hard Wednesdays. This track is my favorite. We are past the top of the hour. This track is entitled This I Don't Need. It's from the 2001 album Leave Here a Stranger. It's Christian, guys, from Tooth and Nail Records. Starfire 59, Jason Martin. Hope you enjoy it. I'll be right back for the rest of hour two. Hang tight.
Good friends.
Wasn't that nice? Shout out to Starflyer 59. I took a second. Nice selection, James. It's hippy dippy, says the real Tim Scott, not to be confused with the rhino. Little Jesus and Mary Chains type, almost. Yeah, I agree, boy, 1999. I like Jesus and Mary Chain. Man, actually sounds cool, says Nessio. Shout out, Nessio. Nice piano. Is there a piano? I think there was xylophone. And I like the guitar. Dun, 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 dun. Almost sounded like Sugar Ray. Remember Sugar Ray? Anyway, thank you guys for bearing with me through the beautiful music. For some reason, my Facebook didn't start. What the heck? My Facebook stream didn't start. That stinks. I'm disappointed. and I toggled it off, tried to toggle it back on again. Maybe I remove it and reconnect it, because this is important to me. Facebook Live, continue to Facebook. Yes, continue. And we'll see what happens. Pardon me with this strange interlude. I like having it go right. What in the world? They're not even letting me go onto my own Hake channel. That's odd. Cancel. Facebook Live. Oh, well, I guess I'll have to, I couldn't go live on Facebook today. Sorry, Facebook crew. It's not my fault, I don't think. What a mess. I got some super chats to read, though, guys. Buck up, Hake. Everything doesn't always go your way. You can't always get what you want. I just want this stuff to work. Too bad. Over on buymeacoffee.com/thehakereport, Popcorn's Thump King says, what? Responding to Keith yesterday, caller Keith, I was remiss in not reading your super chat, Popcorn's Thump Keg, not King. What does Hillary's height, race, or age have to do with anything? That's shallow. Trump is white, 6'3", and 77, and conveniently just a pound or so below the weight considered to be obese, according to Popcorn's Thump Keg. Does that tell you anything about him? That tells you he's a man, and he's the man for the job as president. In Keith's defense, he talked about all these blacks voting for Hillary. This short, white, old woman voting for her, simping for her. Pathetic. Blacks have physicality. If you ain't physical, you ain't black. So how are you going to look at this little, not that little, old white woman, anti-white, so-called white woman, Hillary Clinton, and think, that's a leader, I'm going to vote for that. You got to be a lame-o simp and not a man, you blacks who voted for Hillary Clinton. Embarrassing. Even black females who voted for Hillary. Pathetic. You know that's not a leader. A leader has some physicality. I'm chuckling because I glanced up at myself. And I glanced up at my physicality. And it made me laugh. Laugh because I have true physicality. I laugh because it's true. But yeah. Trump. You look at Trump as a man, that's a leader. You look at Hillary, that's not a leader. From the spiritual all the way down to the physical, nothing about her says leader, says man for the job. She's not a man, she's not for the job, and she's not for the blacks or anybody but herself. And Satan's, whatever. Beautiful Hillary, we call her. Popcorn's Thump Keg continues. Also, in another segment, you mentioned women working and not starting families until later in life. This is not very pithy, okay? I'm not very pithy. Yeah, that's true. What age do you think is ideal for women having kids, generally? Teens, 20s is ideal age for women to have children, according to science, what I understand from science, not that I know any science, but certainly not their 30s. I mean, I know it happens, ladies. It sometimes happens, especially nowadays. They've sabotaged you and you've self-sabotaged. It's true. Just accept reality. Accept what is. Be happy. The joy of the Lord is your strength, ladies. But yeah, that's what I would say. Having kids later in life, it's a risk. It's a risk. It's a risk for the child, and it's a risk to you. It's a risk all around. Look it up. It's a fact. People have kids at 50, though.
Whoa.
I know. Good for them. Also, I already said that. It's also funny that on air you say, that's the world, but you wear a shirt that spells it out plainly. Logic? Oh, the S word. But you wear a shirt that spells it out plainly. Oh, S word, S-E-X, that word? It's funny on air I say the S word rather than the S-E blank word. Sorry, kids, parents. But I have a shirt that says, stop having sex out of wedlock. Well, JLP has it. I designed it, though. logic? The logic is the word, that big old three-letter word, the S word, the three-letter one, catches the eye. It catches the eye. And a lot of people, that's not such a bad word to them. But on Hake's show, we don't profusely use it so much. Profusely? I don't know. We don't use it so much. You can say it now and then, but not too much. When I was a kid, I heard the word and I didn't even know what it was. You have to have S in order to have a baby. I'm like, no, you have to get married first. And then you have the S. And then you have kids. But I didn't say that, and then you have the S. And my friends, my classmates, I should say, not friends. They were sort of friends. We're like, hey, James thinks, because my first name is James. And they weren't calling me Hake then. James thinks you just get married and you wait a while and then you start to have kids. No, I didn't say that. I'm reacting. These people put words in your mouth that you didn't even say or mean, but they don't know. That's the world. All right, more super chats. Amusing, thank you, Popcorn Stumpcake. Base America first bought a coffee. Happy Valentine's Day to one of our favorite women on Wacky Woman Wednesday, Sonia Sotomayor. Sonia. Did you know that it's called Sonia? Not Sonia. It's Sonia. Or Yesenia. It's not Yesenia. If you're Hispanic. Sonia. Sotomayor. Something like that. Sotomayor. In her own words, quote, I live in frustration. Every loss truly traumatizes me in my stomach and in my heart. I'm tired. There used to be a time when we had a good chunk of the summer break. I know. Yeah, summer vacation. Not anymore. Asked about colleagues, Sonia Sotomayor stated, quote, if you look for the good in people, you can deal with the bad more easily. She's friends. Isn't she friends with Justice Clarence Thomas? We have a different way of understanding what's good for the country and the law, unquote. Fortunately, she's a wise Latina, says Based America First, or writes he, who can see the bad in people and interpret in plain meaning the law based on her feelings for what's good. No love from the demon rats. Nearly 70, obese and diabetic. They're calling for Sotomayor to resign so Biden can replace her with a younger judicial activist before Sonia becomes the next RPG. Really? I did not know that. Is that true? That's messed up. She just barely got appointed by Obama. Like less than... I was going to say 10. Less than 15 years ago, I think. Yeah, it was definitely less than 15 years ago because it's 2024, which would take us back to 09. I don't think it was the first month that he appointed her, was it? Obama? Because Obama took the office back in 2009. Wow. That you get her out of there. Get her out of there. Nice. That's funny, Base America First. Yeah, she'll get replaced with somebody even worse. I bet you they want to replace her, too, because she's spoken well of Clarence Thomas. She's stood with Clarence Thomas. She's not for this thing trying to pretend like Clarence Thomas is this corrupt person who's taking money from billionaires. They all take money. They all take, or whatever. And it doesn't affect how they rule because they already think how the way they think. Clarence Thomas especially. Clarence Thomas is not swayed by any billionaire. Give me a break. Nor his wife, by the way. He stands on what's just for the most part, I think. Nice. Thank you, Base America First. That's interesting. Another super chat. This one from Esoteric. 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 He bought a coffee. Hey, Hake, I must have misheard yesterday. It's must have, not must of. But he wrote must of. I learned that from my geometry teacher in freshman year high school. It's must of, must have. But he says must of. Heard, misheard yesterday. I thought the guy had a choice of 180 days in jail or 10 years probation. Oh, yeah, no, it was 180 days in jail and 10 years probation, pretty sure. Reason why I said criminals or drug users or criminals or drug users, when given a choice, would rather take the shortened jail time and avoid a long probation is because you mess up and commit a crime on probation or you deal with a failing a random drug or alcohol test. They can reinstate the full original charges and extend or change your probation conditions. That makes sense. You're being babysat. Babysit. Whatever. When you're on probation. It makes sense, Esoteric. Yeah. The criminals would rather be free to continue and use the illegal drugs or commit crimes after the sentence with no strings attached. Not on probation. Wow. Yeah, probation's a mess. When did they start probation? I wonder. Because, you know, these ex-cons are not allowed to vote. Which I'm kind of for that because it's mostly blacks. And liberals. Liberals are the ones who commit the most crimes. Pretty sure. They tend to be Democrat. They tend to be raised by women. And so they think like women, so they're Democrat. Okay? They don't have their fathers. They're not logical. They are far from God. Criminals. Exceptions to the rule. Many rough around the edges, Proud Boys. Rough around the edges, Trump supporters. Hispanics, whites, blacks. You know, they shoved police officers at January 6th. Some of them. Or pepper sprayed them or whatever. They, too, were criminals. Liberals, because they're emotional and angry, but they see that Trump is for the right man for the job, but they're just too emotional about it, and they commit crimes. Yeah, it doesn't make sense. If you're, as Asmodor has said, our resident historian, if you are too dangerous to own a gun, you're too dangerous to be out in the world. So you should be in jail, or in prison, or whatever. Death penalty, whatever, I don't know. Yeah. Yes. So I'm not for this, you have to wear an ankle monitor, you can't have a gun. You can't, well, I guess I'm for you not voting, because it's not a right. But the Second Amendment, that's a right. But now that you know that you're not going to be able to have that right, you should avoid committing crimes or getting accused of committing crimes, which is another iffy thing. Because you can get accused and convicted when you haven't done what they said you did, that you did. Yeah. Whew. Thank you, Esoteric. Nice. Yeah, true. Carver bought a coffee over on buymeacoffee.com/thehakereport. Hey, Hake, you remember how a couple years ago they swapped the real Biden out with the imposter body double whom is running the country now, or who is running the country now? Whom the country is running now? I would volunteer yourself to do the same in case anything happens to Prince Harry. Oh, yeah, I'll be the next Prince Harry. Come here, Meghan. Just kidding. I disavow that. If we play our cards right, if you play your cards right, you could be doing Hake News from Buckingham Palace. Kind of like that Prince and the Pauper story. That's right, the Pauper. I remember Prince and the Pauper. The Pauper boy looked a lot like the Prince, but he was just a pauper. A pauper being a a homeless bum kid, thief, something like that. And he looked just like him. Maybe Harry would even be willing to let you fill in and just get out of his own mess. Worth a shot, says Carver. That's amusing. That's amusing. Let me make sure. Is Joelle Friday's show scheduled yet? Let me plug in Joelle Friday's show if I can. Friday TV. Yes, indeed. His view of Valentine's Day. And it has lions on it. Catch Joelle Friday TV coming up next, guys. Joelle Friday TV coming on the scene. Coming on the scene. Catch him. He talks about relationships, and it's very pertinent because it's Valentine's Day. Valentine was a real Christian saint, by the way, and he did not do this kissing up, kissy-kissy, hake sliding into Meghan Markle's DMs. No, I disavow that. I'm a faithful man, and I don't do mess with previously married women or women who have children. So far, so good, anyway. I'm faithful, so-called. What was I talking about? Catch Joelle Friday TV. But Prince, yeah, St. Valentine, he gave gifts to, like, friends, I think. Right? Or was that St. Patrick? But he was a saint. He was a legitimate man, I think. There was another super chat that came in from Popcorn's Thump Keg. You seem to be critical of every picture of couples that you show on your program because it doesn't look right, man. You criticize the pictures of Meghan and Harry. It's M-E-G-H-A-N. Okay, spell it right. There are many ways to spell Meghan. Yours is not one of them, I don't think. Could be wrong. And Harry, look at her, all smiling with her hand on his. Or, did they lighten her skin? Yeah, they lighten Obama's skin in these pictures. These colorist people. Kind of like racist, but colorist. Then in other pictures of couples, I heard you say, look at her with that evil look. Would you rather a man and his wife stand at attention with blank stares? Maybe. First of all, it's not natural. Second, it's for the ego of primarily the woman. It's kind of like what JLP said about the PDAs, public displays of affection, where they're kissing in public and hugging and making out. Macking used to mean making out when I was in high school, at least from the context that I gleaned. That's what I thought it meant. They're macking in the hallway. It's like show off, and it's nasty. Kids know something is wrong with it. They see somebody kissing, they're like, ugh. And I get that you fall into the draw of kissing when you actually do it. I get that. But that's, other than that, it's just, that just proves that it is emotional, sensual, carnal, flesh, sin. Stuff, or you know, something that you should like kind of keep a little private, have a little shame. You look weak, you're showing your weakness. You're showing this is my girl, and if you get to her, you're gonna get to me because you're hurting my feelings. So it's not good. Be private. What's the longest that you've had a girlfriend? Well, I'm not answering that question. Why don't you find a woman and show us how it's done? Because I don't have to show you how it's done. That's dumb. That's showing off. For one. And two, because that's... God's not leading my life like that, apparently. And three... One can say what's right or wrong without living it. One knows right and wrong by looking at it, kind of, often. I think. One does not need to be showing how it's done in that sense. It's good if you can show how it's done. If you have the opportunity, yeah, of course. I don't even know that anybody does it right. How else do all the kids get messed up? So watch Hake turn into, well, we're not going to go there. You said you were into raspy-voiced girls. I didn't say that. What's your type? I got no type. I only know that song because of Dylon. I.e. more than mildly attractive. No, they don't have to be more than mildly attractive. They can just be mildly attractive. That's great. Don't be all so selfish. Shallow. Well, it's shallow either way, honestly. Since you seem to take issue with every couple that looks, quote-unquote, odd, I'm not trying to attack you. It just seems like any time a man, woman remotely shows affection, you nitpick. Yeah, I do. For one, it's a shtick. For two, it's true. There's some truth to it. And for three, slap me upside the head if you ever see me being a lame-o, like, beta, hairy. But gently, not too hard of a slap. Be gentle. Okay, last super chat real quick, I think. Man, I saw a documentary on two guys who ran away from a fundamentalist Mormon community. It was hard to watch. These guys were in their mid-20s, told stories how the church ran their life. Also talked about guys around their age who would go to the hospital asking why their wife wasn't pregnant after being married. They didn't realize it didn't just happen. Like you had to put in some action. I don't know if I believe that this popcorn's thump keg. Real cult-like stuff. It was eye-opening to see that happens when you try to suppress natural human hormones, emotions, etc. Yeah, I get that. I get if you're trying to be suppressive of that. Yeah. These guys were in their 20s and had no idea how to interact with society. Well, everybody has their issues. Shout out to the Mormons. They may be doing it the opposite of extreme of the evil world. The evil world has no business looking down on the Mormons, except that they are evil. The evil world is evil. And the Mormons oftentimes could be evil too. Probably more often than not. We are, not me, but, because I'm not Mormon, but human beings are evil after all. Yeah. The answer, I'll tell you one thing, is not that S word education, edumamification. That's not the answer. Mormons, those Mormon boys, probably living better life than you and me. Popcorn's thump keg, in some ways. Shout out to the Mormons. Let me double check over on Rumble. D-Live, I did see a D-Live. Meghan Markle has Harry's golf stuff in her purse, says Evgeny Crosby. We keep them clean, Evgeny Crosby. You put something messed, and I got in trouble because it was not clean. What a mess. Frederick is out of Los Angeles. Thank you for calling, Frederick. What's up?
How's it going, Hake?
Going well. Thank you.
Sorry about the miscommunication we had. I thought you said we was going to have Dr. Cornell West as a guest. It was in Nick Stream's chat on Friday. I could have sworn I thought this was. It was a miscommunication.
Yeah, it was a total miscommunication. I didn't intend that at all.
Not a problem. But I was definitely going to come for a sit-in. You know that.
Yep.
But let me ask you, did you see any of the reports, the news articles after the Tucker Carlson interview that was talking about Putin and his lies?
Who did this thing about Putin and his so-called lies?
Fact checkers.
Oh, please. No, I did not see anything like that. I would be somewhat interested in that. I wonder what Tucker would think of those so-called fact checks, because fact checkers tend to be liberals and they call stuff wrong that is sometimes true, sometimes right. Or they say, oh, something needs more context or stuff like that. What was the gist? Do you have the gist of it?
The gist of it was like he was putting out his propaganda about the N-word, not the one N-word, but the one
nuclear.
Daniel was having a conversation about, like, who are the N-word?
Nazis?
Yeah.
Nazis, nay. Yeah.
Yeah, I think like you got.
Oh, so they're trying to fact check him on the Ukrainian notification thing.
Yeah.
Well, that's not. Were these fact checkers Russians?
What?
Were these fact checkers Russians?
I don't know. They're probably Ukrainians.
Oh, really?
No,
I mean, if the fact checkers could be Americans. I mean, I generally kind of assumed that it was.
I don't know if I don't know the nationality of the fact checkers.
The reason I ask, and it doesn't have to be, it's not like you have to be Russian to know what the Russian sense of a Nazi is, right? But the Russian sense of a Nazi is different from your sense or my sense of a Nazi.
I understand.
Yeah.
It's the whole West. I was trying to pinpoint, like, please let me know who we funding here.
Right.
And I didn't know. Yeah, we funding the West, or just funding the West. I understand that, but I didn't think he was calling us. Why didn't he just say you, Carlson Tucker? You're the Nazi boy.
Right.
You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
I confuses people instead of just beating around the bush. Talk to the people. That's all I want to know. Like, you confusing us with who's who. Is it a group?
Yeah.
Is it a militia? Is it a SWAT team? Is it the government? Is it Zelensky's boy? I'm really, like, who do y'all, who? That's what I'll just be asking, but
I don't even,
I know now. It's anything west of Russia's, Mama Russia's borders.
Right. Kevin Howe says Putin literally calls the whole country Nazis. His definition of Nazi is a nationalist for Ukraine. Interesting. So yeah, Kevin Howe is sort of a Ukraine sympathizer, though.
I guess. Yeah, I got it. So, like, there's...
But he pointed out that Zelensky is Jewish.
In Taiwan. We can say there's Nazis in Taiwan against China, right? It's us, the West, is in Taiwan against China, right? They're Nazis.
Because they're nationalists for Taiwan? They want to be... Is that what you're using it?
Like,
is that how you're
America,
using it?
The West part is controlling Taiwan. Is like, I guess they're Nazis. Like, is that what Putin would think? There's Nazis in Taiwan. That's why China wants them, and we're going to go to war with them because they calling us Nazis. I don't want to. I got to separate myself. You see what I'm saying? I've been saying this.
Yeah, I understand you. Yeah, that's what I thought that Putin's ploy was. I thought that Putin knew that everybody recoils at the term Nazi in the so-called West. And so he's kissing up to that. But as Cash Daily says on X, Cash Daily X, he says, just like Putin said, Nazism has been glorified by the Ukrainian government. They have statues and ceremonies. And it's not just the Germans. The Germans use Polish or somebody else and others?
But what they call it Nazism is democracy, right?
Democracy, yeah. Maybe, I guess.
In the West. Yes. Come on,
democracy. You think that we have democracy?
Yes. That's the West. That's anything, not a dictatorship like they want in Mother Russia, commie.
But Russia is a democracy too. Wasn't Putin voted in?
Come on.
You're just throwing around the term democracy like it means something. It doesn't mean anything. Means the people. Democracy means the mob rule, right? The people vote, the majority gets the win.
Democracy means we have the right to come to your country. If you don't have democracy, we're gonna overthrow the regime that's in power and set up our own and call it a democracy.
That's so true, man. I like that you raised that point. I love that.
Yeah.
That's so dumb.
You can't have a dictatorship. We're gonna come in and make it a democracy and hint, hint, NATO, whatever. We got our hands in it. Hey, all it is.
So you agree with me that this democracy mess. I say that in order not to say crap, kids. Don't say that, kids. Is evil, stupid. It's just an excuse to... It's basically the fake religion. It's the false religion. It's the pretense of their religion is democracy. We're going to go spread democracy. Back in the good old days, we used to spread Christianity through war, right?
Do you think we have a democracy in America?
No, I mean, yes.
No.
Why not?
If we had a democracy, Hillary would be the president, and she won the popular vote. We have electoral vote, and that's a republic.
Right.
So when you get this electoral vote, and it comes out by the winner,
electoral college,
Trump gets the popular vote,
Right.
The electoral vote is going to go with Biden because that's who the oligarchs want in power.
Yeah.
They control the electoral vote. So it don't matter what the popular vote says. We've right. already seen this.
Right. But look, yeah, I agree that we do have a republic, but we have yeah, but we are getting more towards democracy, meaning every idiot gets all the masses
of machine votes don't even count votes. What are you talking about?
No, I'm talking about the useful idiots, the masses, the unwashed masses.
Yeah, they think they voting and they're not even really voting.
But they're swaying and brainwashing the people, and so it's being democracy is the all the idiots voting. And the mob rule, and the mob is getting their way, you'll notice.
Mob, no.
The mob meaning the crowds.
Two devils fighting.
The crowds.
The mob is one, and then the other devils is privately voting. The silent majority, that's just the silent devil. They still two devils fighting.
Yeah, I agree with that.
Yeah, two duopolies. They after the same thing, and it's your money.
You voting
they
for Trump?
Slaves. What? Get out of here. You already know what's going on. I'm trying to tell you, it's Trump for a one state or two state. If he don't say it out loud, I ain't vote for Trump.
But look at all these people who are for two state solution. You're bringing up this two state solution thing. Look at all these people who are for two state solution, and they're the phoniest politicians ever. Why would you fall
the
for that?
The president of the United States. What do you mean, Blinken? Biden.
Yeah, all of them.
Lloyd
Obama.
Austin, all of them for a two-state.
Yeah, I'm talking about for years now. For years, people have been talking about two-state solution. There have been no solution.
Well, they need to leave them alone.
That's what Trump would do.
Leave them alone.
Your best chance.
Go inside the borders of Israel and stay in Israel. Tell them. Israel, stay in Israel and get the hell out of there.
Whoa.
Leave Palestine alone.
H-E double toothpicks. Your best chance with that is Trump. Your best chance for peace is Trump.
You don't even know where he stands. You just hoping. He's a yes man.
But to be honest, this is not an issue for me. Like, I don't care about the Middle East.
You don't care about World War III?
Your best chance at avoiding World War III is Trump.
Do you care about it?
Not really. It's not real yet at this point.
It's real.
But your best chance, I'm telling you, is Trump. With Trump, we had
Trump
more...
is telling people to attack NATO. He's making us be adding more people to NATO. Like, go take whatever land you want, and we're going to protect them and
Frederick,
get their money because they're going to need security.
Frederick, do you know that that's just words? That's not actual war?
No, that's real talk.
That's
who's
real talk, yes. Yes, it's real talk, yeah. But it's also... Those people are going to buck up and start paying for NATO now.
No, what about countries that's not in NATO? They're going to go take countries, and then that's going to be against the damn law of the Geneva Convention, too. You can't just take countries that's not in NATO.
Frederick, you're in your imagination. You have no idea what's going to happen. Stop.
No, I'm
calm
just
down.
Saying, if you encourage a country that's encroaching on another country, take other countries because they're not paying their portion.
Right.
That's just going to make other countries ask, can they be in NATO? Because they're going to be praying victim because they don't have no security. So they're going to make us world police. Trump trying to make us world police.
We're already world police.
No, we're trying not to be world police.
That would be nice. Under Trump, you're going to get the best chance for that.
We're trying to stop funding the Ukraine. We're trying to stop being world police, right?
You're already out of the military. What do you care? You're not even in the military anymore. What?
Look, it don't matter. I'm international. I might run for politics. I got
to
get this straight.
Nice.
And one more thing for the kids that's watching.
Yeah.
When you say, what's a good age to have a kid? I mean, have a baby. What's the age again?
The Virgin Mary had Jesus at 13.
Don't say that. Say legal age. Say legal age.
Legal age.
Don't be teens. I don't like that the teens to 20. No, it's
18 and 19 is still legal age.
Yeah, legal age. And don't, because there's way more teens under 18 and 19 than it is. So just be like legal age. adult, legal age, and older. You're confusing the people that's listening.
I disavow that, though.
Weird ideas, and then they'll go try to be like, well, Hank said he's fertile. And then the next thing you know, don't do that. All right, have a good one, Hank.
I get your point, Frederick. Thank you, man. Appreciate you. Alex in California on the line. Alex, thank you for calling, man. What's up?
What's up, Hake? How you doing?
Doing fine, thank you.
All musicians are liberals except for me.
How do you figure?
So I just finished a 10-track album, and the way I was able to do it was removing all emotional connection to the writing process.
Yeah.
So there's, I'm not expressing myself with feelings through my music. I just know what are objectively good riffs and drums and good tone.
Aha, it's a science.
Together.
It's a science.
I made a little system for myself.
Yeah.
Sorry, I'm walking. I'll stop here. I made a little system to write each song, and I was able to pump them all out without even getting angry one time during the whole album.
And you never got emotional? You never got, yeah, that feels, that sounds great, and kind of proud?
Definitely, I've patted myself on the back a few times.
Aha, uh-huh. So. Liberal.
liberal.
Yeah, but that's cool, man. That's true. Like, it becomes sort of, you know, a good songwriter just can pump out good songs. Like Avril Lavigne, Taylor Swift, and Alex from California. And you just know what works. And American Anchor,
yeah,
baby.
Some of us just got the data and the information, and then we just make a system. And
that's right.
It doesn't take feelings and emotions. No one wants to hear all that stuff.
Right. Yep.
Well, some people do.
Right. True. Yeah. I mean, some of that's the draw.
Also, I remember a few weeks back, you mentioned something about playing the bongos back in the day.
Yeah. When I was a kid in Jesus Club, I played the bongos.
I couldn't think of a more liberal instrument to play.
I know. It's terrible. Maybe my mother was an undercover liberal.
What is it? Bolshevik bourgeois, like commie. Let's go sit in the corner and look at art and play bongos.
No, we were singing Jesus Club songs. We were singing, this is the day, boom, 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 this is the day that the Lord has made, that the Lord has made. We will rejoice.
Okay, I'm familiar with that one.
Yeah. We will rejoice and be glad in it, and be glad in it. Dun, dun, dun. Anyway, this is the day.
Yeah, I guess that's acceptable then if you're doing it for Jesus.
Yeah, but it is. Maybe my mother was a liberal. She was like a world music hippie flower girl. I don't know. That's funny, though, man.
Yeah, I just wanted to put that out there, that it is possible to make music without acting like a liberal, I guess.
True. That's cool.
And I know we're running short on time here. I just wanted to end on one thing. The last few weeks or so, Joe from Phoenix has really been laying on you.
Yeah.
And yesterday, he really took tail and ran away from Jesse. I've been calling him out in the chat, like telling him, stop bringing your mess to Hake. Same with Maze.
Yeah.
Him and Maze need to call Jesse with all that nonsense, you know? Cause they're afraid. And exactly what I thought would happen. Joe threw a few jabs or two, and then once Jesse called him out, he hung up on him.
Yeah. He wanted to get in his jabs and run away. That was interesting.
Joe from Phoenix, this is Alex from California. You need to man up. I don't know how old you are, but if you're going to act like that, that's like a little high school child. Like, you don't hit someone and run away.
True.
Follow through.
If
you have an argument, you can explain yourself. You're not a stupid guy.
Right.
You're a smart guy.
Yeah.
You're evil.
That's true. And he's just hung up on the black thing, is what it is.
Yeah,
part of it.
Not all, but most are. The ones who aren't are really awesome, like William.
Yeah.
Great guy. There's a lot of Williams out there, you know, but there's also a lot of Joes. So I'm going to end it on that. And you have a blessed day, Jake.
Thank you, Alex in California. Appreciate you, man. Call me back sometime.
Will do.
All right. Nice. Short and sweet. Hake's mom sounds real nice. Yeah, she is. Let me check for any remaining super chats that I may have missed. Read the chat, the snake pit. How you guys doing? We do have Joelle Friday coming up next. I'm excited to play some music, and I don't have a whole lot of time to play to get into anything else. And I don't like when I try to get into something else and then I rush it and then I miss the super chats. So do catch Joel Friday talking about what Valentine's Day means to him, something to that effect. American Anchor Baby. Ladies, the Women's Forum is tomorrow. So do join that. It's a highlight of the month. I love the men's forums. I go anytime that I can. And it's worth it. Even if you're tired, I get that even the, in the evenings, come like 5, 6, 7, you're feeling a little tired, you will get your energy back. And you will appreciate it. Even if you are tired. So make sure you do attend the Women's Forum, ladies, if you can. My Buy Me a Coffee is not refreshing. By refreshing, I mean the page is not refreshing. The coffees are very refreshing. Thank you guys for the coffees. But what in the world? Recent supporters, just a wheel spinning. Stinks. It stinks. Guys, I'm going to have to end, though. This is Stephen Wiley. It's Stephen Wiley Wednesdays. It's Black History Month. This track is entitled Big Man. It's from the 1988, I guess, album. Wrap It Up. Hope you enjoy it, you musical Philistines. Joel Friday coming up next. Bye.
You better listen good unless you want to go to hell. My real name's Steve, my friends call me Spike, but you can call me anything, whatever you like. My neighborhood was rough, these dudes were bad, and by the time I was 12, I was getting real mad. Yeah, I was the king, I was really on time. I'd grown up with nothing but was starting to climb. I'm rapping with a homeboy about a plan. All he ever wants to talk about is
the big man.
He talks about a guy who makes him feel high. I said, he's a dealer, how much do you buy? He said, I'm not talking drugs. I gave up on the game, so chill out for a minute. I give the dude's name. His name is Jesus, the best in the land. So let me rap to you about
the big man.
I never heard it before, it was all brand new. But it sounded like the kind of thing I wanted into. My friend told me how the man died for me, how the soldiers nailed his body upon the tree. I said, why didn't he do it? What's in it for me? He said, if Jesus hadn't paid the price, you couldn't get free. But I'm already free. You're living in the past. This is the freedom that is really gonna last. He said, if you believe Jesus died for you, he will give you a life that is totally new, and you'll live forever. That's not a lie. I said, it sounds good to me. I think I'll give it a try.
Stephen Wiley.
I went back home, sat in my favorite chair. I bowed my head and then I prayed this prayer. I said, big man, come into my life today. I was mixed up yesterday, but I believe today that Jesus Christ is God. He is the master plan. Now I've got it together because I've got the big man.
Curtis Blow. Who's that? Stephen Wiley's older than him.
He used to tell me what to do. Now I'm tired of his lies and our relationship is through. He worked real hard to do what he can. He said, you're okay. You don't need the big man. The devil is a liar. He wants you to go to hell and to burn up in the fire.
So good, kinda. I grew up on this.
There are so many ways the devil likes to attack. He says you're no good if you don't own a Cadillac. He likes to see people get locked up in jail and see the school kids go all out and fail. He loves to see people curse and swear at one another. He likes to see a dude go out and kill his own brother.
I gotta get out of Joel's way.
What the devil can do, that is no one but the big man inside of you.
Thank you, my son.
With Jesus, I'll tell you all things can happen. And that's the reason I'm standing here rapping. You may think that I'm tripping. You may think I'm jive. Well, no matter what you think, the big man's alive. They may call you names, look at you and laugh a lot. But remember where they're going to. It's gonna be hot. Trying to tell you how it really is. The big man's getting jealous. He wants you to be his. So when you hear this rap coming out of your box, then turn it up loud till it blows off your socks. When you're rapping with the big man,
I want you to blast. Cause he and his people that are really gonna last. Jesus is the answer for me and for